Hello, everybody. I have been telling you for a couple of weeks now that I was going to do a review on a vagus nerve stimulator, and today is that day. So today I'd like to introduce you to the Hoolest VeRelief vagus nerve stimulator. It comes to you in a box like this, which, you know, very nondescript. And then you have their instruction manual, which is very easy to follow. Everything you need comes all in one. Then pop out the little insert and you have, voila, the device. And then you drop some more instructions. This device, because it is a vagus nerve stimulator and uses a transcutaneous electronic nerve stimulation technology, does have electrodes on it, basically, and you will need to periodically replace these, but they are rubber electrodes, so it's not something you have to replace every day. I've had mine for about a month now, and it's still going strong. You initially will get two sets that will come in little containers like this, so you can see the electrode thingies. They're just little, feel kind of rubbery. I'm not sure what they're made out of, but they conduct the current when you are ready to use your vagus nerve stimulator. It also comes with your little power charger that you can use to charge up the device. One charge on the device lasts a really, really long time. I've had mine for, as I said, about a month, and I've used it pretty frequently, and I still haven't had to recharge it, which is really nice, because if you're using it multiple times a day, which I'm not, I'm only using it a couple of times a week, but if you're using it multiple times a day, then you want to know that you don't have to bring the cord and the charger and everything with you to make sure you have it with you. Now, the little device itself, you know, it's about the size of an old-fashioned pager. You take off the top, and it will start flashing, telling you it's on. Then you can crank up the, each time you push this, it turns up the power a little bit. When you're ready, you put it right under your ear and then kind of perpendicular to the ground. And you will start feeling the vibrations from the electricity stimulating your vagus nerve. And I feel it going up behind my ear, and I feel it in my ear, and a little bit on my earlobe and on my tragus, which is exactly where that vagus nerve is. So you hold it there for 3 to 5 minutes, and then you want to switch and move it over here. Now, the neat thing with this device is if you don't have it in the, quote, right space, if you have it over a muscle or over a bone or something, you're not going to feel anything. So you need to move it around to find that sweet spot right under your ear where it targets that nerve. Within a couple of minutes, it will start triggering that relaxation response. Why is that important? Well, the whole reason you're doing this is to help strengthen your vagal tone, to help you trigger that relaxation response when you're feeling overwhelmed, when you're feeling out of control. This is a way to literally manually turn on that vagus nerve response. And as you do that, you're reducing the amount of time you're spending in fight or flight. So you're helping sort of weaken the fight or flight response and strengthen the relaxation response, which will ultimately help improve your hormone parameters, your thyroid balance, your neurotransmitter balance, and help reduce inflammation. Device hasn't been tested in clinical trials like some other devices, but there are a couple of other devices right now that do something similar that are in clinical trials. One was used to reduce the symptoms in infants that are born addicted to opioids, and they found that it was extremely effective at reducing the infant's distress, their parameters of physiological distress, their heart rate, their blood pressure, et cetera, as they are going through withdrawal. So it makes it much nicer for the infants. They have used it in clinical trials with people with alcohol addiction who are detoxing, as well as with people with anxiety and PTSD and borderline personality disorder who experience dysregulation. A lot of those studies haven't been fully published yet, but I encourage you to keep aware of the research because the evidence coming out of these studies is extremely promising. Does it do everything? Of course not. We have to change our physical health behaviors to support neurogenesis, to support health, and we have to change some of our thoughts to thoughts that are of safety and empowerment, not one of panic. So obviously there are things that we have to change in other areas, but we can't effectively learn. We can't effectively apply what we learn if we're in fight or flight. We need to be able to get into our relaxation state. And that is what this vagus nerve stimulator can do. So I encourage you to go to Hoolest, check it out. This is the VeRelief vagus nerve stimulator. They have another product that I am really looking forward to review that is a bilateral headphone set that combines vagus nerve stimulation with the bilateral tones. So I'm really looking forward to that. But this is great. You can put it in your wallet. You can put it in your pocket. You can put it in your purse. You can put it in your briefcase. So you always have it with you. And when you start to feel like you're getting ready to spiral, you can use this and help downregulate.